morning, on a first Friday, we offer Holy Mass for Randy Caccia, or Siaccia. Chacha, excuse me, thank you. Turn your ear, O Lord, and answer me. Save the servant who trusts in you, my God. Have mercy on me, O Lord, for I cry to you all the day long. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, this morning, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who caused the minds of the faithful to unite in a single purpose, grant your people to love what you command and to desire what you promise, that amid the uncertainties of this world, our hearts may be fixed on that place where true gladness is found. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, we earnestly ask and exhort you in the Lord Jesus that, as you received from us, how you should conduct yourselves to please God, and as you are conducting yourselves, you do so even more. For you know what instructions we gave you through the Lord Jesus. This is the will of God, your holiness, that you refrain from immorality, that each of you know how to acquire a wife for himself in holiness and honor, not in lustful passion as do the Gentiles who do not know God. Not to take advantage of or exploit a brother or sister in this matter. For the Lord is an avenger in all these things, as we told you before and solemnly affirmed. For God did not call us to impurity, but to holiness. Therefore, whoever disregards this, disregards not a human being, but God, who also gives us his Holy Spirit to you. The word of the Lord. Rejoice in the Lord, you just. Rejoice in the Lord, you just. The Lord is King. Let the earth rejoice. Let the many isles be glad. Justice and judgment are the foundation of his throne. Rejoice in the Lord, you just. The mountains melt like wax before the Lord of all the earth. The heavens proclaim his justice, and all the peoples see his glory. Rejoice in the Lord, you just. The Lord loves those who hate evil. He guards the lives of his faithful ones from the hand of the wicked. He delivers them. Rejoice in the Lord, you just. Light dawns for the just, and gladness for the upright of heart. Be glad in the Lord, you just, and give thanks to to his holy name. Rejoice in the Lord, you just.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Be vigilant at all times and pray that you may have the strength to stand before the Son of Man. Alleluia. 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 The Lord be with you. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven will be like 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish, and 5 were wise. The foolish ones, when taking their lamps, brought no oil with them, but the wise brought flasks of oil with their lamps. Since the bridegroom was long delayed, they all became drowsy and fell asleep. At midnight, there was a cry, "Behold the bridegroom! Come out to meet him." Then all those virgins got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish ones said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise ones replied, "No, for there may not be enough for us and you. Go instead to the merchants and buy some for yourselves." While they went off to buy it, the bridegroom came. And those who were ready went into the wedding feast with him. Then the door was locked. Afterwards, the other virgins came and said, "Lord, Lord, open the door for us." But he said in reply, "Amen, I say to you, I do not know you. Therefore stay awake, for you know neither the day nor the hour." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Such richness in this Gospel passage. It is pretty rare to hear such detail in a parable, and I hope we don't miss it. 10 virgins, that's peculiar. It's not 10, let's say, people. It's not 10 Christians. It's 10 virgins. And they are wedded, waiting for the wedding of this bridegroom. It's an image of the church and Jesus, the bridegroom. And so, let's say, Jesus is saying, out of these 10, let's say half of the people who try to follow Jesus are foolish. And in this scenario, 5 are wise. The oil is sort of a representation of the interior. You know, for instance, some candles in some churches have like a little stock of oil. This appears to be a real candle, which is a plus for Holy Cross. But otherwise, you have to constantly fill that oil, or it doesn't light. And in a time before there was electricity, if the bridegroom should come at night, you would need some type of light to get out to the, even if it's just a few paces, to see him. And at midnight, there is a cry, wakes them from sleep. That sleep is similar, similar actually to death. Sometimes we would say in the scriptures, so-and-so fell asleep. I have to awaken, Jesus says, this little girl, she's just asleep. No, she really died, in a sense, and there's the cry. It's someone announcing the bridegroom and inviting them to come meet him. Just as John the Baptist says later, at some point in history, he says, "Behold the Lamb of God. He is the cry of one in the wilderness." And someone, maybe an angel, maybe one of the saints, when Jesus comes back, is going to announce his coming. And all the virgins get up and trim their lamps. It's kind of, they're getting ready, they're trying to be able to see him. And interestingly enough, the foolish ones have just a little bit of oil left. So their candle has not gone out, but there's really not enough strength left to get to the bridegroom. So they ask for help. It's not possible to help because although Jesus doesn't connect all the dots, I think we know from our experience that you can't share this type of oil, that it's a very personal thing. You know, you can try to give your faith to your kids or offer a witness to another, but only you have the character of your soul. And that's what the oil is referring to. The merchants is a peculiar place. I mean, the wise virgin suggests that the foolish ones go to the merchants and buy some oil. But if it's the character of our soul, it can't really be bought. And what type of merchant would be selling soul oil? I think we don't need to get caught in every detail because parables are not meant to be a 100% lockstep presentation in symbolic form. There's meant to be an approximation. Although there is, I would say, a real clear approximation that merchants relate to money and buying. And sometimes when we live in that world too much, we forget about the soul. So it's peculiar that the wise ones would say, go there, but we can see how that doesn't really help them. In a sense, we don't know if they got it or not. We assume that they did, although it could have just been hours later and now it's sunrise. But anyways, the door is locked. It's a very profound and sad reality. Because elsewhere in Scripture, the door is only locked from the inside. For instance, Jesus comes and knocks on our door of our hearts in Revelation. And anyone who opens the door to him, a handle which is on sort of our side, then he will come and be with them. But he will respect us if our doors are locked. Here, the door seems to be locked as if from outside, which is a symbol of this is the end of all time. This is there's the particular judgment, but this is the final judgment. And at their judgment, these foolish virgins are told that the Lord does not even know them, that they didn't stay awake, that they weren't prepared for the hour. It's a very shocking thing because of us here, how many of us are wise and how many of us are foolish? And how would we know? Well, on this first Friday, let us cling to the Lord's heart and let us ask that Sacred Heart to open our hearts that we may not be locking off parts of us to him and that we may be ready and awake. For whenever the bridegroom comes, we will go to meet him with great joy. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O Lord, who gained for yourself a people by adoption through the one sacrifice offered once for all, bestow graciously on us, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace in your church through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love. His resurrection we confess with unwavering hope. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, and the earth full of your glory, Son of God. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, O Son. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Salvatore, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all. We pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with Blessed Grimwald Santa Maria, and all the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The earth is replete with the fruits of your work, O Lord. You bring forth bread from the earth and wine to cheer the heart. Let us pray. Grant that your faithful, O Lord, whom you nourish and endow with life through the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts that we may merit an everlasting share in his life, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Certainly there's much to pray for, and if I could ask for some prayers, there's a retreat, you might say, for young men, some of whom are considering the priesthood, but others just seeking God and the next step of their faith. So that's going to be this Sunday from 2 to 8. And if you'd say a prayer for those about 12 people that are coming, 12 young men, maybe some would be priests. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil.